What happens to the disc in your neck over 20 years? In 2018, Dr. Kenji Daimon published a research paper addressing that question in the Japanese population. I'm going to summarize the findings. From 1993 to 1996, about 500 neck pain-free healthy volunteers had MRI studies of their neck. After 20 years, each volunteer was then asked to obtain a repeat neck MRI and answer a questionnaire about their current health status. Anyone with a neck injury during that time was excluded from this follow-up study. The original group of volunteers had age ranges from their teens to their early 70s. Of the original approximately 500 volunteers, 193 did consent to obtain both the MRI and answer the health questionnaire. The research paper goes into details about the nature of this 193 subject group and rationale for why this group was representative of the overall volunteer experience. The paper will be referenced below if anyone's curious. The information provided in this paper is consistent with what most practicing spinal specialists see in their practices. Younger people have much less degeneration than older people. The C5, C6 level wears out first, with identified MRI findings seen on a higher level than any other level. In 95% of the volunteers who completed the study, there was wear and tear that worsened significantly at least one disc level in the neck. In 60% of the volunteers, most of the discs to the neck also showed evidence of wear and tear over 20 years. For those over the age of 40, more than 80% had MRI evidence of progression of spinal compression with disc protrusions. From the standpoint of the questionnaire, after 20 years, 45% had complaints of stiff shoulders, 18% had complaints of neck pain, 13% had complaints of headaches, 9% had numbness to their arms, 8% had complaints of ringing to their ears, and about 5% actually had arm radiating pains. So, what does this information mean? The common sense part is that older people have more wear and tear. But the most important is that people without neck pain over time will wear out and develop complaints such as stiffness of shoulders, neck pain, headaches, and numbness. Remember, this is a group of subjects who did not have any known neck injuries. Over 20 years, 95% will increase wear and tear of at least one disc level. This is the aging process. From the standpoint of the surgeon, this paper confirms that many people will have evidence of spinal impingement and disc protrusions as they age, but very few will actually require surgical management. Very few are actually significantly symptomatic from these findings. The paper did suggest that development of foraminal stenosis had some associated increasing arm radiating pains. This paper does lead to more questions. Why does not wear and tear lead to more significant symptoms? If the discs naturally degenerated over time, does injuries change the nature of disc degeneration or the development of complaints related to the disc degeneration? Is this a Japanese genetic population experience only, or does this information also reflect conditions of other ethnic groups? Aging is a gradual process. The body is able to accommodate the slow changes. Perhaps that's why we will have these findings as we age, but few of us will require aggressive treatments such as surgery. At the same time, we do know that there are things that will accelerate this degenerative process. Smoking, excessive weight, bad diet can create a poor environment for our body cells, accelerating the aging process. We must do what we can. We do have some responsibility for our own aging process. With each birth date, we get older and wear out more. Accept it. Do what you can to slow down the aging process. Accommodate the changes and enjoy the cycles of life. If you'd like more information about spinal topics, please subscribe to our newsletter or to our YouTube channel. Thank you.